Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
The Honorable Lecturer Dr. Andi Kaharudin SAP Amhum and all my beloved friends. First of all, let us thanks to the Almighty Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala because of his blessing we are able to come here to join in this English meeting. And don't forget to send salawat and greetings to the great Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam who has brought us from the dark world to the bright world. So today we are going to discuss about your topic, understanding politics. And before that, I will introduce the members of my group. There is Ismail Mubarak as a first speaker, Nurul Aisyah as a second speaker, Ulia Ayu Marsukasa as a third speaker, and myself, Rizka Fibrianti, as a moderator and the last speaker. Okay, for the first question, what do the result of the research indicate regarding the Indonesian learning of English? For the first speaker, Ismail Mubarak, time is yours.
Well, thanks for this opportunity that gave to me. The first question about my answer. The result of the resources indicate regarding the Indonesian learning of English that there is a problem in producing some sound. As we know together, the sound that produced when speaking in English doesn't exist in Indonesian sound system with the learners, which is unfamiliar to with the sound and confusing to distinguish among the consonant and vowel sound, and inability to make the sound correctly. Maybe that's my answer.
Well, thanks for the answer. Well, for the next second speaker, Nurul Aisyah, time is yours.
Well, my answer is the result of the researchers indicate regarding the Indonesian learners of English is most Indonesian learners of English give the first priority to repeat their speech without noticing the articulatory precision of the sound they make, such as vowel and consonant sounds are not correctly placed on a certain word label. Intonation pattern is imprecisely used and words in utterance are spoken without clear-cut borderlines between them. I think that's all for my answer.
Thank you. And we will move to the third speaker, Ulia Ayu Marsukasa. How about you?
Thank you for moderator. My answer is suggestion of research and English teachers are considered to study the benefit of phonetics for study English sound. A problem in production English consonant as it is now that the main goal of learning English for Indonesian language learners is general aimed at improving their skills in communication in English effectively. Thank you. Back to moderator.
Thank you. Thanks for the answer. So for my answer is the result shown from research on Indonesian English learners are that there are several problems faced by English learners in Indonesia. One of them is that the difficulty in learning English occurs due to the fact that some English sounds are not present in the learner's mother tongue. And English sounds that are not available in Indonesian tend to make learners produce error in the articulation of sounds, and these sounds are recognized as problem in producing English sounds. One of the problems is about producing sound. According to the study, one of the problems faced by Indonesian English learners in producing excellent sound is to produce the sound P, which is phonetically known as the labiodental fricative. This sound is one of the sounds that cannot be found faced in the Indonesian phonetic system. In an effort to produce this English sound, Indonesian learners tend to make mistakes by replacing them with V, which is also known as voice labiodental fricative, because the sound P starts the same place and way of articulation, namely the labiodental fricative. The difference is only in the state of the vocal or chords. V is a voice, voice while F is a voice without a voice. Well, thank you. Number two. According to the research, the learner's unfamiliarity with the sound turns into a confusion to distinguish among the consonant and vowel. Sound is an inability to make the sounds correctly. What are the main causal factors of the confusion? For the first speaker, Ismail Mubarak, time is yours.
Thank you. About knowledge is that the main causal factor of the confusion are intonation variants, difficult to produce the sounds well. Yeah, maybe that's my answer. Thank you.
Thank you. For the next second speaker, Nuro Aisha, time is yours.
Well, my answer is the main causal factors of the confusion is there are some consonant and vowel sound in English that are not found in Indonesian language. So students are not familiar with the consonant and vowel. And then the second is the learners do not have knowledge of English phonetic system before they learn English pronunciation. And then students rarely practice English in their daily life because the more often we practice, it will make it easier for us to do the correct pronunciation. That's all for my answer. Thank you.
Well, thank you. We move to the third speaker, Ulia Ayu Marzukasa. Time is yours.
Okay, my answer is the roles of research on the problem of Indonesian English learner in production of consonant and vowels. Therefore, it is important first of all to show that regarding the problem of the learner in production English consonant, the data was but obtained from scientific research consonant by Dion and Justin 2008, who examined six consonant sound met by Indonesian English learners. Conducted to observe the phonological error made by Indonesian English learner to determine the type of error a student in sound that are not in Indonesian sound grammar. Thank you.
Well, thank you. And my answer is, according to research from expert, the main factor causing confusion to distinguish between consonants and vowels are due to the first, some English sounds are absent in the learned mother tongue. The second, learners tend to pronounce vowels in their mother tongue. And the third, learners tend to pronounce word longer if they have the same double vowel, even though the third word shall not be pronounced long. And learners also tend to pronounce short words if they only have one diphthong vowel. Okay, next. Number three, what does the researchers suggest the learner to help them gain a good foundation for good English pronunciation? Why? For the first speaker, Ismail Mubarak, time is yours.
Well, thank you. Following the research results, the researcher of this study recommend that English learners whose mother tongue is Indonesia need to be aware of the pronunciation of the six absurd endless consonantal sounds. Therefore, they need to learn the articulation of the sounds well, that they are able to make the sounds correctly. Because yeah, learning the articulation of the sound means to use phonetic as a valuable tool for improving ambush precision. Well, thank you.
Thanks for the answer. Okay, for the next second speaker, time is yours.
Well, my answer is to suggest that researchers to help them gaining a good foundation for good English pronunciation is there is reading, memorizing, observing, speaking, practice, utilizing existing facilities such as social media. Because with a lot of reading, we will know more the vocabulary. Then we observe how the correct pronunciation of the vocabulary that has been known, as well as often speaking exercise, even though only in front of a mirror. We can also use social media as a media of learning in developing pronunciation skills. That's all from me. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Okay, we move to the third speaker. Speakers, Uya Ayu Marsukasa, time's yours.
Thank you. My answer is to achieve this goal, they must be able to have a knowledge of micro speaking skill, namely English pronunciation, vocabulary, grammar, currency, fluency, and understanding. Thank you. That's my answer.
Well, thank you. And my answer is, following up on the result of the research recommends that English learners and teachers whose mother tongue is Indonesian need to be aware of the pronunciation of the six observed English consonants. Therefore, to get a good foundation in English pronunciation, they need to learn the articulation of odd sounds well so that they can make sounds properly. Learning the articulation of sounds means using phonetics as a valuable tool for improving English pronunciation. Well, number four, what doesn't Townsend's 2014 say regarding some efforts that foreign learners of English need to do to improve their English pronunciation and to minimize or even to avoid pronunciation errors? For the first speaker, Ismail Mubarak, time is yours.
Thank you. According to Townsend 2014, learners of English cannot simply copy their teacher to be able to make a specific sound in English correct. The particular pronoun doesn't exist in the learner's native language. They may actually struggle to hear the sound, let alone reproduce it accurately. For the reason, he further suggests that one way to draw attention to French sounds is to show the learners how to form the English sounds in their mouths. Sounds are formed by using the articulators or organs of the mouth, nose, and throat. These things are all about phonetics. When teaching English pronunciation, English teachers should be able to show exactly how to form the English sound by using their speech organs. This will help the learners to minimize or even to avoid pronunciation errors. Well, thank you.
Thank you. Well, for the next second speaker, time is yours.
Well, my answer is by learning and understanding about phonetics and phonology. And also, we always train our pronunciation skills in our daily lives or at least during the learning process in the classroom. I think that's all for my answer. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, we move to the third speaker, Ulia Ayu Marsukasa. Time is yours.
Okay, my answer is to according to 2014 learners of English connect simply copy their teacher to be able to make a recipe sound in English correctly if a particular phoneme does action in the learner's native language, they may actually struggle to hear the sound, let alone reproduce it accordingly. Thank you.
Well, thank you. And my answer is, according to Towson, 2014, English learners cannot simply imagine their teacher to be able to ascertain sounds in English correctly. If a particular phoneme is not present in the learner's mother tongue, they may actually have a hard time hearing the sound, let alone reproducing it accurately. To that end, he further suggests that one way to draw attention to foreign sounds and to minimize mispronunciation is to show learners how to form English sounds in their mouth. Sounds are formed using the articulators or organs of the mouth, nose, and throat. This includes the upper and lower lips, teeth, tongue, larynx, pharynx, heart, and soft palate, and the unit tissue that lies behind the upper that called the alveolar ridge. Those things are all covered in phonetics. Well, we move to number 5. What does Pallawa 2013 say about the major role of the phonetic system in learning to pronounce and to read words, sentence, or paragraph in a foreign language, particularly English? For the first speaker, Ismail Mubarak, time is yours.
Well, thanks for this opportunity. According to him, English sounds to Indonesian learners create many problems. The problems can be obviously in the error that they make when producing the both vowel and consonants. Well, thank you. That's my answer.
Well, thank you. And for the next second speaker, time is yours.
Well, thank you very much for the time. My answer is, Pallawa state that they refer to the sounds of one's language in the processing of reading and speaking. Successful acquisition of phonological representations needs accurate perception of phonetics. It is proved empirically that phonological system help in the development of fine reading and speaking. I think that's all for my answer. Thank you.
Thank you. And we move to the third speaker, Ulia Ayu Marsukasa. Time is yours.
Okay, my answer is, according to him, the sound of English for Indonesian student causes many problems. The problem is clearly seen in the mistakes they make when producing vowels and consonants in the record Powell Pallawa 2030 argues that the persistent distribution of the student mother tongue system in the target language is a contributing factor. Thank you.
Well, thank you. And in my answer, Pallawa 2013 also comment that the phonetic system plays a major role in learning to pronounce and read words, sentence, or paragraph in a foreign language, especially English, because according to him, the sound of English for Indonesian students causes many problems. The problem is clearly seen in the mistakes they make when producing sounds, but vowels and consonant. In this case, Pallawa 2013 argues that the consonant interference of the native language system of the students in the target language is the causative factor. Well, we move to the sixth number. What the Brown 2000 and Sturckel 2003 say about the principal barrier to second language acquisition? For the first speaker, Ismail Mubarak.
Well, thanks for this opportunity.
About answer for number 6. The principal barrier to second language acquisition is the interference of the first language system with the second language system, and that is scientific. Structural analysis of the two languages in questions would yield a taxonomy of linguistic contrasts between them, which in turn would enable the linguist to predict the difficulties learned would encounter. Well, thank you. That's my answer.
Thank you. Well, for the next second speaker, Nurul Aisyah, time is yours.
Well, thank you very much for the time. Brown 2000 claims that principal barrier to second language acquisition is the interference of the first language system with the second language system, and that the scientific structural analysis of the two languages in question would yield a taxonomy of linguistic contrast between them, which in turn would enable the linguist to predict the difficulties of learner would encounter. Will Struckle 2003 confirms that since the learner tends to transfer the habits of his native language structure to the foreign language, we have here the major sources of difficulty or easy in learning the structure of a foreign language. I think that's all for my answer. Thank you.
Well, thank you. And we will move to the third speaker, Uya Ayu Marsukasa. Time is yours.
Thank you, moderator. My answer is also claims that the principal barrier to second language acquisition is the interference of the first language system with the second language system, and that a scientific structural analysis of the two languages in question would yield a taxonomy of linguistic contrast between them, which in turn would enable the linguist to predict the difficulties a learner will encounter. Thank you.
Thank you for the answer. So for my answer is, Brown 2000 also stated that the main obstacle in the acquisition of a second language is the interference of the first language system with the second language system, and that's scientific and structural analysis of the two languages in question will result in taxonomy of linguistic contrast between them, which in turn will enable expert linguists to predict the difficulty that students will face. In addition, Starkle 2003 assert that because learners tend to transfer the habitual structure of their mother tongue to a foreign language, here we have a major source of difficulty or ease in learning the structure of a foreign language. A similar structure will be easy to learn because it will transfer and can work well in a foreign language. But the different structure will be difficult because when moved, they will not function properly in the foreign language and therefore have to be changed. Well, we move on the last number. What does Pallawa suggest to minimize the effect of the native language, especially initiation? Why? For the first speaker is my...
Well, thanks for this. Maybe I will answer the last questions. To minimize the effect of the native language, especially in pronunciation, Pallawa further recommends that successful acquisition of phonological representation needs accurate perception of phonemic, because it has been proved empirically that phonetical system helps in a development of fine reading and speaking. Thank you.
Well, thank you. For the next second speaker, Nurul Aisyah, time is yours.
Well, thank you for the opportunity. Paulo was suggest, based on quotes from Brown and Strockel, similar structures would be easy to learn because they would be transferred and could function satisfactorily in a foreign language. The different structures would be difficult because when transferred, they would not function satisfactorily in a foreign language and therefore would have to be changed. I think that's all for my answer. Thank you for the time.
Well, thank you. And we move to the third speaker, Ulia Ayu Marsukasa. How about you?
My answer is therefore to my meaning the effect recommended that such full question of phonological recognition needed a correct fraction of phonemic because it has been proved empirical that phonetical system helps in the development of fine reading and speaking. Thank you. That's my answer.
Well, thank you. Okay, so for my answer is to minimize the influence of mother tongue, especially in pronunciation, Alawa further recommends that the successful acquisition of phonological representation requires accurate phonemic perception because it has been empirically proven that the phonetic system helps in the development of good reading and speaking. Well, after hearing the answer from each speaker, does anyone want to report or give advice from the speaker? And if there is a refutation or give advice, please address to whom. Well, if not, that's our discussion today. Let's say alhamdulillah together. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alamin.
Thank you, guys. And assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.